Oh, yeah.
So you're about to now chisel out this thing.
Yeah, back to here. I just made a mark here, so it gives me a ledge. And then I'm just going to take a smaller chisel. The goal here is to cut out Monopoly pieces, which you'll see what I mean in a minute. Because this... Here, I got one down here. This is one I cut out from another one.
Oh.
So I'm just kind of cutting it so the triangle until there's not much there, and then you can just chop it off with a chisel. Cut it down like that.
So, are you calling those little pieces Monopoly pieces?
Well, no, the big piece that's coming out. I'm going to do the other side.
So it's going to get really close.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you're basically making a triangle.
Oh, triangle. So it's real small at the bottom,
I think. Mm-hmm. I'm trying not to have a habit of wanting to put my finger under here, which is a bad idea, because if you're doing this and you slip, you don't want to
cut yourself. Because those are very sharp, right? Yeah, those chisels are very sharp. Yes, are they like a knife?
Let's see. Maybe you can see if you... I'm going to have to sharpen this one a little bit, but... If I had a regular piece of paper, you'd see I could just like slice it right in half.
Yeah. It's scary, isn't it? So you probably can cut yourself before you realize you've cut yourself.
That's right.
Sometimes.
But the nice thing is, once you do start to cut yourself, you usually stop pushing on the chisel.
Yeah.
Hopefully. So now, I should be able to knock these out with this. If I was making something really nice, you know, I would do this a few times back and forth so that you'd hit the chisel again, go back and do that again, but for these, you can kind of cut corners. So I'll just hit it again on each side. That'll get it deeper. So you can see where I cut it down now even deeper.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'll do the other side. And I do this side first because you see
how the inside.
Well, if I now with this next hit, I'll be able to knock this out of there.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a little tight. So if I did this side first and then this side knocked it out,
it would
wedge it in there and
it could break.
And it'll break this. So. Which I've done.
Oh yeah. So it's not intuitive. You have to actually think about it.
Think about it. There you go. That's what you mean, little Monopoly pieces.
Oh, let me see. Oh, they look like little houses.
Yeah, exactly.
Or the hotels.
There we go. Sometimes they get stuck.
Cool.
And then there's still little pieces of wood that get stuck in there.
Hold on. Yeah?
So I'll just clean that up.
With what?
With a chisel.
Oh, chisels.
Like I said, you know, I was doing something really nice. You do a little bit more care, so this would be more smooth. But
so this is pine, right?
This is pine.
So it's a little bit softer.
It's softer wood, so you can get through faster. It kind of tears more anyway because the grain is so thick. So coarse.
Open.
Coarse, yeah.
Whatever. Open.
That's the right word. So.
But if this is like black walnut, this would be taking you forever.
It wouldn't be forever, but maybe three or four iterations instead. I just did one. But that was just one corner of the box. So you can see it could take a long time So then I'll see this should fit. I won't do it.
You just check to see if it fits?
I don't usually check anymore.
Oh. That's cool though. It fits.
Because every time you do this, it stretches the joint.
Oh, it's not good for it.
Yeah. But all I do is glue it, pound it together, and then...
Are you going to glue it now?
No.
I'm
going to do all four sides first.
Oh, yeah.
Because that was just one side. I think it looks cool because it's kind of like a puzzle.
Yeah, it is.
Or a Chinese puzzle, those things that fit together.
Yeah. Cool. Okay. Did I already see you pounding it together? I think I did, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
Okay, bye. Thanks, Pat. Bye.